So, hello friends, this is Shivam Sundram back again with the CSIR and JRF previous year questions. So, this time on the special request of my viewers, I am going to explain you guys numerical problems from the physics and some from the geology. So, I hope you like it. Please do comment, like, share and subscribe. So, start with the first question. So, the question is, a 20 centimeter cube of a rock measures a resistance of 200 ohm. Now the resistivity of the rock is, so suppose this is the rock, this wooden block is the rock, okay. Now we have to find resistivity. So the side of the cube is 20 centimeter, okay, it's given. And if we see that in every option, the answer is in meter, right? Here it is in meter, 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 okay. Now we have to convert this length, which is in 20 centimeter, to the meter. So it becomes 0.2 meter. And the resistance given is 200 ohm. And the area of the cube, that is L square or side square, so it becomes 0.4 meter square. Now the formula for resistance is R is equal to rho L by A. Here R is equal to resistance, rho is resistivity, L is length, and A is the area of cross section. So when we put all the given things in this formula, the resistivity becomes 40 ohm per meter. So the right answer is 4. And this question is from 2015 June, okay, and from part B, okay. So it's very important question. Every year, like in 2016, the same type of question is also asked about resistance. So the next question is, if the average density of the rock in the crust is 275 not kg per meter cube and the value of the g, that is acceleration due to gravity, is 10 meter per second square, then what is the value of lithostatic stress at the depth of 35 kilometer in the crust? So this stress is nothing but force per unit area, and in the same way pressure is also force per unit area. So the equation of lithostatic stress or hydrostatic pressure is the same, that is P is equal to rho gh. So the P is pressure here, or you can say stress, the other case. Rho is the density, g is the acceleration due to gravity. So we consider here acceleration due to gravity as 10. In the given question, it's 10 meter per second square, okay. Now the depth, that is height or depth, so h is some given is 35 kilometer, okay. Now we have to convert this in meter because the average density is in meter cube and acceleration due to gravity is also in meter. So 35 kilometer becomes 35,000 meters. So when we put all these things in the given formula, the lithostatic pressure becomes 962.5 megapascal. Now why mega? So it becomes, if you calculate, there are six zeros at last. So we convert into the megapascal thing. Pascal to the megapascal. Okay. So the right answer is one. So the question third is, an electromagnetic wave at 100 hertz can penetrate to the depth of 100 meter. Then an electromagnetic wave of 400 hertz will penetrate to the depth of what? So suppose there are two waves, one is of 100 hertz, one is of 400 hertz. The 100 hertz one penetrate to the depth of 100 meters. So what will be the depth for the 400 one frequency? So the important concept behind this question is, the depth penetration of electromagnetic radiation depends upon the two things. The first thing is electrical conductivity, and the second one is the frequency of the radiation. So the relation here, it's given is frequency and the depth. So the relation between depth and frequency is this one. Like depth is inversely proportional to under root times of the frequency. Now when we use this formula for this problem, we convert in this form like this. So d2 becomes d1 into under root times of f1 by f2. So putting all the given in this formula, we get d2 is equal to 50 meters. So this question is from part C of 2015. Okay. So moving to the next question. So the fourth question is a Cubic wooden block of density 0.8 gram per centimeter cube when floats in the water have an exposure of 2 centimeter above the water level. The side of the cube is. So suppose this smaller cube is of density 0.8 gram per centimeter cube, and now it floats in the water. So the exposure above the water is 0.2 centimeter. Now we have to find the length of this cube. So suppose this thing, length of the cube. Now the given is density 0.8 gram per centimeter cube, length, let the length of the cube is x centimeter, right? So this whole thing become x, okay? Now the mass, we know that mass equal to density into volume, or density is equal to mass by volume. So the formula becomes 0.8 into x cube, since the side is x, right? So the volume becomes cube of the x. So the mass becomes 0.8 into x cube. Now we know that according to Arkundi's principle, that when a body is fully or partially submerged in a fluid, it experiences an upward force, and that upward force is equal to mass of displaced water by its volume. Okay. Now, the mass of displaced water is equal to its volume. So, the volume inside the water is x into x into x minus 2. Since 2 centimeter is above the water, so below the water it becomes x minus 2. So this thing is also a mass, this thing is also a mass. So we equate both the masses, and the equation becomes like this. So when we solve this equation, x becomes 10 centimeter. So the side of the cube is 10 centimeter, right? So moving to the next question. So the last question is, the resistance measured across the face of the smallest area of cross section is 5 cm into 5 cm into 10 cm. So this is the volume of the cube of a block of a material 8 ohm. So suppose this is the block having side 5 cm, 5 cm and 10 cm, and its resistance is 8 ohm when the resistance measured across the smallest area. Since this 5 cm and this 5 cm makes the smallest area of the cube, this face, okay? Now, when we measure the resistance along this area, it becomes 8 ohm, okay? So, we have to find the resistance measured across the face of the largest area of cross section of the same block. So, this is the largest area, right? The second figure. Since this area becomes 25, right? Length into length. So 5 into 5 becomes 25. Here 5 into 10 becomes 50. So this face is the largest face. So we have to find the resistance along the largest area. So the formula for resistance is R equal to rho L by A. We know that. Okay, so the rho is resistivity, L is the length, and area, A is the area of cross section. Now the given resistance for the first figure is 8 ohm, means the resistance measured along the smaller area, that is 25 centimeter square. When we put this given things into the formula, the resistivity becomes 20. Okay. Now we know that the resistivity is the same for both the diagrams. Either we measured along the greater face or the smaller face. So the we put this resistivity into the next formula. Now here the resistivity becomes 20, and L is 5, since this thing is 5. Okay. So we are measuring along this side. So it becomes 5, and the area, rho L by A, no. So the area becomes 50, since 5 into 10 is equal to 50. So area, it's the largest area. So we put 50 here, and we got the answer 2 ohm. So this is the last question. Thank you very much. Hope you like it. Please do subscribe, comment, and like.